Hopefully I'm recording and you can hear me. I got the back shock cranked down about halfway. I just weighed myself. I'm 196. Well, I got all kinds of gear on right now because I ain't used to this bike. I'm just gonna, it's about warmed up right now. Chokes off. It's about, I don't know, 55 degrees. Beautiful. Let's see what's up. It's 4SB, by the way, because you didn't watch the other video. Neutral is down and it's 4 up. Has a lot more power than you think for a little 125. The nice thing is you can stand up. Won't be doing much of that. Revving it for no reason. Don't need my light. Yeah, you can feel a lot more on the underneath. I really don't want to get this thing all muddy. Because I really want to, well, probably going to anyway. But. Electric start's nice. Now see, that's something I would never do on a mountain bike, or I mean a mini bike. Look at that. See, that's what's nice. You can stand up on the thing and not as much traction. Where am I going? Oh wow, I'm almost up to that other trail. Hoo-wee. I'm stuck on a rock. Ooh, there's a snake. Sorry, buddy. Apparently, I'm in a rock quarry. Oops. I think I'm out of shape. Okay, I'm going back down. I'd never make it anywhere near this far on a mini bike though. Ugh. Hey man, I'd rather be doing this than running down the road with a mask on for exercise. Okay. I made it pretty far. In first gear, it's just tractors. It's nice. So many trees. Oh well, I think I'd rather just ride and get muddy and clean it off than try to avoid it. I'm up on the pegs. Man, in first gear, this thing has all kinds of little low-end torque. It's nice. Okay. I got on my bike to cool off with all this gear, not to... Not new anymore. Another thing I forgot to mention, this thing was all jacked up, and every time I'd reverse, it'd get caught up in the chain and the tire. So I had to cut a big chunk out. I guess it's running okay now. Whoa. The throttle's a little bit, there is some slack, but that's how you adjust your throttle. Third gear, this is third. More trees on. I think I'll go this way. Third gear is a little too tall for climbing, but first and second work nice. Oh man. Ooh. Keep shifting down, trying to get into first. So even though this seat's a lot harder than any of my mini bikes, the geometry of the bike make it so you can stand up and absorb bumps. Oh, I'm going over. Damn, like a gas. I didn't know that was gonna happen. So I got all the gear on. Not hurt one bit. When this is on its side, it just dumps gas. I thought I saw a trail. So I love this thing though. I don't care if I drop it. On the TW, I shouldn't care, but I do. Because it's such a beautiful little bike. I mean, mine is. I just don't want to. It's so, so nice. I don't want to wreck it. I'd rather just buy a junky old bike and take off-road. That TW is sweet. So anyway, one of these days I'll bring it up here. Oh man, this is a fun bike though. Ooh-wee. What is this over here, man? And the brakes, the front brakes remind me of TW200 brakes. And the rear brakes are really good. You can lock them up kind of at will. The front brakes are kind of a little bit, you know, they're not really strong, but that's good. You don't want them really strong on a bike like this. But they do work. If you hear a clattering when I'm engine braking downhill, the chain slaps around a little bit, but it's not loose. See how the handlebars are like up a little bit? When I built it, I had them going straight with the forks, and it felt like they were too close, and I couldn't stand up very well on the bike at all. They're still kind of low for that, but it's good. So I moved them in, so when I crashed, wouldn't be hanging out here, it'd be broken right now. So anyway, I put them upright a little bit, and it gives you a little more room, which is nice. I think I can still add some risers, you know. And I think if I added some risers, I think it'll be even more comfortable and easier to stand up. Oh, is there a tree down up there? Yeah. Yeah, second gear could use some more get up and go, but it's, hey, it's a 125. I think it's doing pretty good with my chunky butt on it with all this gear. Glad I had it on, because I landed on some rocks and roots that probably would have hurt pretty bad. Yeah. Oh! Oh! Yeah, this thing is fun. I just feel like it's way more dangerous, which is probably why it's more fun. But it's, you know, I'll get better at riding it too, you know. I've never ridden a tiny little dirt bike like this, and it's different. Where am I going? Yeah, see, I'm locking up the back brake, no problem. I want to rip up this trail all the way from the bottom. Oh, it's just the sun glinting off my headlight. I thought the headlight was on when I turned it off. Yeah, so let's go down here and rip back up here. Yeah. Whoa. Hear that? It's a chain. I think it's okay. See, back brake. We can easily lock it up. The turning radius on this thing. Kind of crap. Get it revving, it has some beans. Meant to go up there, but oh, I go down there. Ah. See, I'm just gently using my back brakes and engine braking. Yeah, man. Yeah, you can sit down and just cruise too. Obviously, you can't go as fast if you're sitting down, but second gear. Yeah, second gear is nice for the woods. I mean, you're not gonna go too fast, but that's okay. I'm not trying to race anybody. Just trying to have fun. Get some exercise. Learn a new skill. Riding in a tiny dirt bike. Soft right here. It's down here. Thought I put it in neutral. It's hard to get used to a different gear shift pattern when you're so used to one down, four up. Oh, look at this. Yeah, so you can just putt around on this bike. First gear, sit down, putt around just like it's a little mini bike. But see, my knees are, my legs are right under me. I can pop right up and stay up. See, I can, you know, you can't do that on a mini bike. Well, maybe the MB200 you could after you move the pegs, but I still don't think it's the same. Wow, look at this. I've been over here in a while. See, that was just crazy mud, like totally hidden. Oh geez. Yeah, see? I think that's just mud under there, but see, now look at the ground. Now look at that. Spinning, spinning, spinning. Spinning, spinning, spinning. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, look, it's dry. Oh, wait. Crazy. I feel like I'm in quicksand. Jeez. You can just never tell where there's gonna be a foot of mud under there. I don't really know where I am right now, second. Holy cow, what is that giant ditch? Yeah, I'm leaving a trench wherever I go. Look at that. Oh no. Well, this is a pretty good test for this thing because where's all my trails at? Oh, here's one. Seem kind of silly to avoid this mud now, but talk about cardio. I think this bike weighs about the same amount as I do. I think it's like 173 pounds or something like that, 179. I wonder if there's something to that. If your bike weighs exactly the same amount as you do, if there's some kind of equilibrium. Oh yeah, I'm coming down this other part here. We had to try to go up this. Well, I know it's gonna be no problem for this thing. Whoa, muddy. See, now I don't want to tear this up. If I tear this up, county has a reason to say, hey, get out of there. I do have the GPS on my GoPro, but I don't know how good that works. Yeah, see front brake? Look at this. It works.